We're getting Monday drunk. Drank a lot of them, and I'm not gonna stop. Corey, what are we drinking today?
Today we've got Founders All Day IPA Session Ale. It's a delicious beer. We've had it before, and I bet you we'll have it again. 4.7 ABV for a 12-ounce can, and yeah, it's super delicious, man. 42 IBUs, you gotta love it.
Yeah, it's my favorite beer on the planet. Lately, we've been kind of making our way through a Bud Light variety pack. And today, I said, Corey, I need regular beer.
Yeah.
So that's what we're doing. So that's delicious. For those of you who have never had this, this is like a lower ABV beer, like Corey was saying too. And it's just, you can slam like three or four of these. It's like the most light beer, craft beer hybrid I've ever found.
I kind of think of it as like, people who like hoppy flavor, it's like a really hoppy light beer. It's like if Bud Light was hoppy.
Yeah, and it's tame hops too. Like some people who are like, whoa, I can't do it. This is like a good transition into IPAs.
Oh dude, it's probably the best IPA transition beer.
I agree 100%.
This is gonna get you from being like, oh, I've been drinking Bud Lights and Coors Light, which I love, I'm not talking, all I drink is Natty Light, so
right.
You know, I'm not hating, but. This will get you, if you're trying to become like an IPA guy, this is the one to take you there.
I agree. Lower ABV, and they're really good after like a day of skiing, a day at the lake.
Summer days, yeah.
A summer day on the beach. Yeah, maybe you're just in your driveway. Dude, all the IPAs are there.
Maybe you're just an alcoholic who likes hops.
Yeah,
this
maybe you're meetings at 7 and you got a couple hours before it.
Yeah, you want to drink at work but not get caught?
Yeah.
Put these under your desk and chug them. It'll help you kind of level out. You don't have to get too blacked out, you know?
And today, Dexter Holland's hot sauces.
That's right, the offspring.
Dude, you guys know Dexter Holland. Even if you don't think you do because the offspring. I won't pay, no
way. Now, why don't you get a job? Great offspring story.
Okay.
When I was in Germany, the big festival, Rock'em Ring, go to that festival, you camp out and you get hammered and then you walk to the shows and stuff. And this German dude came up who was blacked out. All he wanted to do was go see the Offspring. And we were like, yeah, man, you can hang out with us. And he spoke almost no English, was asking for fire, which was like a whole predicament because he was like, I thought he wanted to light a cigarette.
Yeah.
But no, he wanted to build a fire so that he could burn his clothes, the shirt that he was wearing. He took it off, lit it on fire, then went to his campsite, took one of his friend's shoes, like you take your shoes off before you go in the tent, and started chucking them into the woods. And then on his way walking back, fell into another one of his friend's tents and wrecked it. And just fell down into a tent, was like, burr! And then I gave him, I was like, bro, I'll give you all the things in my pockets for your shirt.
Yeah.
He had a button-up shirt.
Oh, this is the guy you bought a shirt from.
I bought a shirt from him, which I've done a couple of, I think three times in my life, I've traded either traded my clothes or purchased clothing off of people. And I bought this guy's button-up shirt. I bought his button-up shirt, so he must have lit, he lit something on fire.
Yeah.
So some part of his clothes, but I bought his shirt. But yeah, and then we went and saw Offspring. We were supposed to all go together, and somehow we lost him. I never saw him again.
Did you ever, so I own the shirt?
No, it was an ugly button-up. There is a picture on Facebook, I'll see if I can find it.
Yeah.
That I had like posing with this really drunk guy.
Oh, if you can find that, show them, oh, that'd be so good.
So great.
The mind and stories and life of Corey Wagner is just some sort of a vacuum of time.
Yeah, dude.
Stuff just keeps happening.
It's wild, wild.
So let's go ahead and see. We really love Gringo Bandito sauces. We've done, I think, that one and maybe one other before, big fans.
Yeah.
So shout out to their PR team sending us these. This video is unsponsored. We're paid zero money. We're just gonna run the gambit of all five of them now.
Yep.
To see how good the whole lineup is. What's our first one?
Our first one is the original from Gringo Bandito, which by the way, do you know the name of their company?
No.
Hungry Punker. Love that.
Oh, that is Huntington Beach, California.
Love that, because it's a punk rock band, obviously.
Huntington Beach really crushes the hot sauce game. That's where Truff is.
Oh, the Kings.
The Kings.
I mean, other than Sixer sauce.
Yeah, they're the Queens. All right, the original Gringo Bandito. Cheers.
Cheers. Mmm. It's been a while since we have it. This is good.
Yeah, I think I still have a couple in my fridge.
Decent heat. like not overpowering, but definitely there.
Mm-hmm.
Flavor, excellent. A lot of garlic.
You know what that reminds me of?
What's that?
It's like a tastier Frank's.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
That's what I get.
Vinegar-based, which is like very much in the Frank's realm.
Mm-hmm.
But you're right, it's got a lot better of a flavor profile, in my opinion.
Yeah. There's just more to it.
What a dumb sentence.
Really, like, lot better.
Good adjectives, dummy.
Well, for some reason, I know everything about grammar, so.
I literally don't know what a pronoun is. I literally have no clue what a pronoun is.
He, she, we, they.
I'm not gonna remember that.
What's our second sauce?
Second up, we've got the Gringo Bandido green sauce. This is their take, I assume, on like a verde type.
Yeah, this is Shrek's cum.
Ugh, it's very, it doesn't have very thick cum, it's very liquidy.
I'm not editing this one. Verde, cheers.
Cheers. Mm-hmm, man, this is really good.
Fresh.
You nailed it. It has totally a fresh flavor to it.
That's way better than most verde sauces. We talk about this all the time. I feel like once you make a red sauce as a hot sauce company, you have to graduate to making a green sauce, and a lot of them are so bland because just like fresh veggies and like some not a lot of flavor. That's great.
This is really good.
What's the main pepper in that? Is it bell peppers?
No, dude, habanero.
What's like the non-spicy pepper? Is there another
serrano? And then it just says more peppers. Literally, dude. Look at that.
I love when these places like and more stuff too. I don't think you're allowed to do that. We talk about this too. People sleep on serrano peppers.
Oh.
When you're at the grocery store, get a bag of serrano peppers and just start having a gas of a party.
Little skinny boys.
They're so good.
They're so freaking good.
The next one is spicy yellow, which is made with scotch bonnet peppers.
Oh, the good stuff.
Habanero peppers and Mexican onion. Mexican onion. Cheers.
Cheers. Mmm. Oh, wow.
Oh, very oniony.
Oh, I love onion. So that's
oh my
really
god,
good.
That's really unique. Holy smokes, that's really good.
Yeah.
Dibs.
Having not had these before, these are both really good.
My tongue is dancing.
Yeah, those scotch bonnets, dude.
I think scotch bonnet, I think it's my favorite pepper. I'm in a real scotch bonnet.
Yeah, dude. Because they're like, the heat that scotch bonnets bring are aggressive.
Isn't it like 100,000 Scovilles?
Is that right?
I think it's like really high.
I know they bring a lot of heat, but it's still not to that overpowering where, like, what is it, the scorpion that we don't like? Or
scorpion pepper is like the under the tongue heat.
Yeah, which I don't care for.
Dude, scotch bonnet peppers. I wanna buy some scotch bonnet peppers.
Yeah.
Is there a pepper shop in Chicago? Why am I doing the shocker? Let us know. Another one we haven't had. Oh, dude, look at the beautiful label.
Very stoked for this.
So we got a bunch of Gringo Bandidos. 5 of them for Corey, 5 of them for me, 5 of them for Patrick, our manager, but only one bottle of this.
Oh, that's what's up.
So this is the Private Reserve, and it features red Fresno peppers and double mojo.
Ooh.
Like, I have no idea what that, it's like Austin Powers mojo. Private Reserve, cheers.
Cheers. That's good.
That's super, I don't know what that flavor is. Like, I don't know, that's spicy.
Yeah, that's got a good kick to it. That has got great heat, even a little hotter than the scotch bonnet, I think, with great flavor. Are you bowling?
In a way.
There you go.
All right, our final one here today is the super hot. It's got a black label on it, and you know it's gonna hurt. This has got, oh, mother effer. It's got scorpion peppers and the Jolokia chili peppers. All right, super hot, cheers.
Cheers.
Here's the thing. You start eating it, and then it buries itself in your tongue. Mm-hmm. Scorpions like to do that.
I don't like the flavor profile of that one as much.
Me neither. I think, honestly, they've done a good job of like not making that so hot that you don't want to eat it.
I just don't really like the flavor of that one as much, especially relative to these, because all of these, to me, are phenomenal flavorings. Like, these are
I think I have a favorite. I think I know which one I like the best, because to your point, there's so much flavor in all those.
Mm-hmm.
This does have a lot of flavor. It's just not a flavor that I would reach for.
Right.
Yeah, I think I have a favorite.
Wow, that's tough.
All right, before we go ahead and pick a favorite here today of the Gringo Bandido sauces by Dexter Holland, let's do a shout out.
Merch out, merch out, merch out.
Number6forcheese.com is our website. And there, you can buy a bunch of stuff to support the show. Sauces, sunglasses, stickers, t-shirts, and koozies. So today, like we like to do on our Monday videos, we're gonna shout out 2 people that are loyal fans that bought from the FUP, the First Up program. You buy more than one item, we say your name faster. So today, 2 names. Merch shout out number 1 goes to Mr. Clint Stevens.
Woo-hoo!
fan of the show, bought two Sixer sauces. That's our hot sauce that we sell. Boom, you can get that. Clint, thanks for buying two.
Mm-hmm. And merch order number two goes to Mike Q. From It's Raining Babies, awesome crew.
So YouTubers.
Couple different YouTube channels that that crew's got. The Midwest Brewing Review, you guys have seen them in some of our vlogs. They're awesome folks. Mike's part of the Pilots Watching Pilots, which is another great channel.
Yeah.
Check both those channels out. All those folks are awesome. And Mike got a single Sixer sauce.
Okay.
And then also a white koozie. So he's getting
Oh,
this is the unemployable.
I know that that crew likes to drink, so I know that koozie will be used
a lot.
All right, guys, thank you so much for supporting the show. Go to the website. You guys keep buying stuff. The hot sauce ships immediately, literally out the door as soon as you buy it. Chef Iron Mike's been amazing, so snag it. All right, Corey Wagner, now's the time to pick your favorite of the five sauces. On the count of three, snag your favorite sauce, and maybe you'll get to take it home with you in a basket of plastic. Ready?
Mm-hmm.
One, two, three.
You loved it, huh? The spicy yellow.
There's something about a liquefied manila folder that I like.
It seriously tastes
so good. This was so unique. You don't have spicy yellow.
Yeah, and it wasn't even like, I assumed it would be like a mustard base.
It's not.
But it didn't, I didn't have that mustard flavor.
Mexican onion.
Very, very, very unique.
Man, this is great. This is the winner here today. You can head over to Gringo Bendito. I think they sell all their sauces on Amazon too. We obviously get paid $0 if you buy any of them. So if you really do endorse what we say, buy it. There's another sentence that made little to no sense.
Thanks to the Gringo Bendito crew for sending these through, man. We really do appreciate that. And these were all really freaking good.
Fantastic. I'm gonna even look up exactly
who it was.
Bob Bradley.
What up, Bob Bradley?
Bob Bradley, thank you so much for sending those, that whole crew. Awesome. Dude, how about you say we do this again tomorrow, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday?
Yeah, let's keep the train rolling.
Mm-hmm. I'm gonna go hit the treadmill. See you guys tomorrow, 10 o'clock Eastern, for another video. Sure, I'll have a drink.
You kind of look like Cartman. Have we ever told you that?
Yeah, you kind of look like Timmy.